exchanges with a combined market value of $1.2 trillion.
What?
Stephen Shelton's nomination to the Federal Reserve Board was blocked in the U.S. Senate today. And it's a blow to President Donald Trump's drive to reshape the U.S. Central Bank before he leaves office. After two Republican senators were forced into quarantine, the GOP was left short of the votes that needed to overcome Democratic opposition. Much after Republican senators Mitt Romney and Susan Collins voted against Shelton's nomination. Once the outcome is clear, Senator George Reed and McConnell should still vote to keep him low. That's a practical move that would allow him to bring the nomination up for reconsideration.
Meantime, in the Senate, we have a challenge to Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg and Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey. The debate here was over how these companies moderate online speech. Now, during the Judiciary Committee hearing, lawmakers called for changes to legal protections for social media companies. Ed Ludlow has more.
Republican committee members accused the social media companies of content policies that disproportionately silence conservative views. Committee members on both sides of the aisle also said that there was a 2-minute post by President Trump about election fraud and him falsely claiming victims. Dorsey and Zuckerberg said they were open to reform of Section 230, a law which gives legal liability protections to all websites who host third-party content. But neither they nor committee members say suggesting what this change should be. In San Francisco, Edward Rose, Donald Trump has ordered the Pentagon to accelerate the drawdown of U.S. troops in Afghanistan and Iraq. And that's the book of the news.
That's exactly right, Paul. Donald Trump has ordered the Pentagon. He wants 2,500 in each to be left. Acting Defense Secretary Chris Miller said, really no change in the plan.
This is consistent with our established plan and strategic objectives. Supported by the American people, and does not equate to a change in U.S. policy or objective.
Yeah, this has been a campaign pledge by Mr. Trump, but it comes in transition to Joe Biden, who is still not getting briefings. And Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, in a rare Trump review.
I think it's a precipitous drawdown in either Afghanistan or Iraq, to be safe. I chose publicly yesterday. And I hope that it's all true.
Humiliation akin to the American withdrawal from Vietnam. Even without the White House briefing, Joe Biden is leading a head calling a group of advisors together today to talk about security and health.
There's been still a lot of damage done the last 4 years in Nigeria, and we need to rebuild our institutions and our workforce to reflect the full strength and diversity of our country.
Now, one CEO who has spoken with Mr. Biden is Marriott CEO Arne Sorensen, who here on Bloomberg's New Economy Forum says he told the president-elect,
"We are trying to focus on COVID-19 and then the governing to bring back growth and to bring us all together."
In many respects, that's the best.
Yeah, eyes on the Georgia recount today. Election Administrator Gabriel Sterling says nothing has really changed the outcome.
Winner is the winner, and person came in second place came in second place. Now to get ahead of some of the other questions, this hand audit we're doing right now, it's safe to move the certification.
And so it's just being done. Now to get that certification, he says there won't be any change in the outcome. Meanwhile, the Pennsylvania Supreme Court has reversed a ruling that allowed Trump campaign observers to get within 6 feet of the ballot counting process, reversing a rare Trump campaign victory. And Mr. Trump has fired the Homeland Security official in charge of the election security, Cyber Security Director Chris